There's a new giant rising in the Atacama Desert. And no, I don't mean ESO's ELT, which will be the largest optical telescope in the world. A further record-breaking observatory is about to join it. But why do we need another one? This new facility, the Cherenkov Telescope Array Observatory, or CTAO, will look nothing like the ELT. It will also observe very different things. Supernova explosions, matter being accreted by black holes, gamma ray bursts. In short, the most energetic phenomena in the universe. These are best studied using gamma rays, a very different part of the electromagnetic spectrum to what the ELT observes, and one that is blocked by our atmosphere. The fact that gamma rays don't make it all the way down to the ground is good for us and our health, but less great when you want to observe them. And that's why the first gamma ray telescopes were space-based. So why are we now building this one here, down on Earth? For most telescopes, our atmosphere is a problem, something to be overcome. But for the CTAO, the atmosphere in a way forms part of the detector. The telescopes on the ground will detect not the gamma rays themselves, but the faint blue glow induced by them as they travel through our atmosphere faster than the speed of light. Cherenkov radiation. But wait a minute. Particles traveling faster than the speed of light? Isn't that breaking some fundamental law of physics or something? No, nothing can travel faster than light in a vacuum. But in a medium, such as the atmosphere, the speed of light is lower, meaning that it can be exceeded by highly energetic particles. Similar to a sonic boom, when the speed of sound is exceeded, these faster-than-light particles can then emit a short, faint, and very blurry blue flash. This blue, visible light can be observed from the ground, but since it's so faint, it needs very clear, dark skies. That's why it's being built in the Chilean Atacama Desert and will be hosted within our Paranal Observatory. Or at least part of it will be. In order to catch gamma rays hitting both the northern and the southern skies, the CTAO will be distributed across two sites. The southern one in Chile and a northern one on the Canary island of La Palma. It's a massive project led by an international partnership, including ESO and countries around the world. The CTAO will not just be one single telescope. It will instead consist of over 60 dishes spread across the two sites. They'll come in three sizes: small, medium, and large. But the CTAO is no interferometer like, say, ALMA. The light waves recorded by the individual telescopes will not be combined into one coherent signal. Instead, the many telescopes will be used to observe the Cherenkov flash from slightly different positions, allowing us to pinpoint its location and infer the direction and the energy of the incoming gamma ray. Because of the way the CTAO is set up, it will be able to observe a huge range of energies. The northern side will have large and medium telescopes and will be optimized to detect gamma rays with lower to medium energies, between about 20 gigaelectron volts and 5 teraelectron volts. These produce relatively faint Cherenkov flashes that are best detected with larger dishes. The southern side, on the other hand, will contain many small telescopes spread over an area of about 3 square kilometers. They will detect the highest energy gamma rays, which produce brighter flashes but are rarer, which means they're best detected by many small telescopes. The telescopes at the CTAO south site will be able to detect gamma rays up to 300 teraelectron volts, going to much higher energies than any previous gamma ray telescope. For comparison, this is 23 times more energy than created in the most violent collision at the world's most powerful particle accelerator, CERN's Large Hadron Collider. The CTAO will allow us to explore a whole new part of the electromagnetic spectrum and enable completely new science. The CTAO will help us understand the most extreme energetic environments in the universe, like supernova remnants or supermassive black holes. These places act like cosmic particle accelerators, producing what are commonly known as cosmic rays, subatomic particles accelerated to nearly the speed of light. As they interact with matter, magnetic fields, or light, they produce gamma rays, which we can then observe. We also want to understand gamma ray bursts, which are believed to involve ultra-fast jets of plasma ejected from black holes, the clash of two neutron stars, or other events. These are among the most powerful phenomena in the universe, but much about them is still a mystery. Another mystery we hope to solve with the CTAO is dark matter. Normal matter, made up of protons, electrons, and neutrons, makes up only about 15% of all of the matter in the universe. The rest is dark matter, but we don't actually know what it's made of. Current leading theories predict that dark matter particles may produce gamma rays when they collide or interact with each other, in a process known as annihilation, or when they decay. With the CTAO, we may be able to finally find out what type of particle dark matter is really made of. Today, the foundation is being laid for an observatory that has the potential to revolutionize high-energy astrophysics, the same way ALMA did for the millimeter and submillimeter regime, and the same way the ELT will for the optical and the infrared. There is already one prototype telescope and three more under construction at the CTAO North site, while the first telescopes for CTAO South will arrive on Paranal in the coming year. What I'm most excited about is the potential for discovering the unexpected. The CTAO will be the most sensitive gamma-ray instrument built to date, capable of detecting even very faint signals. What new gamma-ray sources will we find? What new mysteries will we unravel? Stay tuned.